This is a story about empty space. The millimeters of empty space between the lens of a smartphone camera and its sensor, and how this has changed over time. You may have noticed its effects when you take a picture of a landscape and it looks tiny, or a building which feels really far away, or any close-range object only to have a bunch of background details sneaking into the edges, and of course, cats. That distance between lens and sensor determines what an image from a camera looks like. In a world where smartphone images form the aether of visual communication, a change has quietly transformed that image. Smartphone cameras have become increasingly wide, or in other words, present a greater field of view. When we see images captured on smartphone cameras as much as we see with our own eyes, the change in a smartphone's perspective becomes a change in our own perspective. This shapes even our memories. When we look at pictures such as these from the 2000s, it supplies the tone of our mental imagination of the era. So let's zoom in. What does it mean for an image to be wide, and why have things moved in this direction? First, a quick review on the mechanics of photography. A camera is a mechanism that uses a lens to concentrate light on a sensor which captures the image. The focal length is a distance between the two. A short lens is called a wide or wide-angle lens. It has a wide field of view because the lens takes in light from a wide angle and focuses it onto the sensor. The opposite of wide is telephoto, describing lenses that are long, which permit only a narrow field of view. This is the mechanism by which adjustable lenses zoom. A lens zooms in not by simply expanding the image, but by extending the lens and projecting a smaller field of view onto the sensor. Indeed, on a power zoom lens, the controls are labeled not plus and minus, but W and T for wide and telephoto. This setting strongly determines the look of an image. What matters is the ratio between the focal length and the size of the sensor. In absolute terms, the lens of a smartphone is extremely small, but since it only has to focus light onto a tiny sensor, it can still achieve the same view as a large camera. For historical reasons relating to film standards, in photography, focal lengths are often discussed in 35mm equivalents, that is, how long the lens would have to be if the sensor were scaled to be 35mm wide. A standard focal length that is said to closely approximate what the human eye perceives is 50mm. This is a popular length for lenses that come prepackaged with cameras, a baseline neither exceptionally wide nor telephoto. Smartphones today have focal lengths around 24 to 26mm on the main camera. This is very wide and reflects the culmination of a rapid progression from the approximately 35mm of the original iPhone in 2007 to 33mm with the iPhone 5 camera in 2012 to cameras as wide as 26 to 28mm by 2016 with the Samsung Galaxy S7 and iPhone 8. If you've upgraded your phone over these years without being mindful of this unadvertised trend, you might have consciously or subconsciously noticed changes in your photography. Was it always so hard to take a picture without getting your toes or legs in the frame? Not at all. On a 35mm camera, it's nearly impossible to accidentally capture stray limbs in a photograph. At modern focal lengths around 25mm, it's ubiquitous. A wide-angle photograph also introduces distortion. We can see this with images from Wikipedia by Ashley Pomeroy. Almost all camera lenses are designed to provide a rectilinear projection, which preserves the straightness of lines. This is an important property. If something is straight in the world, we would like for it to be straight in an image. However, this introduces size and angle distortion, especially at the edge of the image. To contrast this, consider this transformation of the same image as if it were captured with a fisheye lens, which is designed for curvilinear projection. These projections can display a large field of view in a smaller space with less distortion. The glass panels to the right in the rectilinear view grow massive approaching the edge of the image, but remain a more constant size in the curvilinear projection. However, this doesn't preserve the straightness of lines. Finally, note that distortion becomes noticeable only in the wide frame. If we crop down to the image that would have been taken on a longer lens, we see in both images their respective distortion mostly disappears. Understanding now how these fields of views have changed in physical terms, we can ask why this happened and how does it affect in a more abstract sense how we perceive the world. Two perspectives are critical, the tech product aspect and the cultural aspect. As a tech product, I've struggled to find definitive industry reporting where engineers or press releases justify the expanded field of view with each generation. My own reasoning is based on basic imaging science. We understand that a wider image is inclusive of all narrower images through cropping. In other words, an image captured with a 25mm lens can be cropped down to basically the same field of view as you would get with a 35mm lens. A user can create a narrower image if that's the look that they want. This doesn't go the other way around. If you take a picture on a 35mm lens, there's no way to zoom out or uncrop in post-production. If you're taking a picture of something close to you, as smartphone users often are, it's therefore valuable to allow you to capture it in its entirety without having to move away first. Therefore, providing a wider base lens gives more options to the savvy user, who can just digitally zoom into their ideal field of view. Since smartphone cameras have such high resolutions, they can do so without losing image quality. Technological trends seem all in on the wide angle. An analysis of patents for mobile cameras reveals a trend from 2014 onwards of a focus on cameras with wider FOVs. Notice the outliers for extremely wide and extremely telephoto lenses. These, I believe, reflect another innovation, the use of multiple cameras in a package to give further flexibility and augment a main camera that is already highly capable and highly wide. Despite the flexibility, most people will simply point and shoot, relying on the default focal length. To infer why this might also be acceptable, we consider cultural aspects of having a wider field of view through analogy to other widening trends through history. In one of the only written analyses of the wide-angle perspective of cell phone photography that I could find, photographer and scholar David Bate in Camera, Phones, and Mobile Intimacies relates current trends to photography in the mid-20th century. He begins his analysis with photographer Henri Cartier-Bresson, who captured iconic images with a 50mm lens as a standard focal length. Then, in the 1960s, a new generation of photographers came to the fore with images on wider lenses, 35mm to 24mm. In 1967, pictures by three photographers featuring a variety of street scenes on these wide lenses were displayed in an influential exhibition, New Documents, at the Museum of Modern Art. Bates writes that beyond the wide-angle lens facilitating deep focus on a technical level, it also showed more of the scene and gave a more dynamic relation between the viewer and the events, people, and objects in the photographs. This relation, this look, was an important characteristic of photography in the 1960s. Bates and another scholar, Marius Nedelcu, also analyzed the use of wide images in cinema, particularly as a way of providing a more immersive experience to compete with television. To immerse the viewers and provide a sense of spectacle, Nedelcu covers a wide range of technologies and gimmicks involving multiple projections to create a panorama, to surround sound, and even ways to deliver specific smells as a part of a film screening. These trends have continued to the present day, as immersive platforms like 360-degree video, VR headsets, and elaborate mechanical edifices like the Las Vegas Sphere promise ever more panoramic views. We have seen two dimensions of the wide-angle smartphone lens. Technological advancement providing more megapixels and multiple lenses enables and even encourages going aggressively wide to give more choice to the user. Meanwhile, wide lenses also yield a better sense of immersion, an element to images that has been sought after in the past. However, the smartphone is of course neither a pure technological or cultural object. In another view, it is the intersection of these that is critical. Chris Cheshire, in a detailed analysis of the iPhone camera's place in photography, points out that even though the original iPhone is remembered as a benchmark of mobile photography, it didn't have technically impressive camera hardware. With a low resolution of 2 megapixels, fixed focus, and lacking even a zoom function, it only kept up with its camera phone contemporaries. What made it impactful was the universe of technologies around it, both for on-device storage and connectivity, as well as social technologies for the uploading and sharing of images. The ability to not just take a picture, but also instantly and widely distribute it is what made the iPhone and its cell phone photography paradigm a cultural mainstay. Cats are a case study. This isn't rigorous, but me reasoning through something I've observed, the transformation of the tone, the humor, and the look of cat memes. We still feel the reverberations of the lolcat era, even though cat memes don't look like this anymore. Summarizing their themes in hindsight, many of them were representational, anthropomorphizing, and tended to show mimicry, placing the cat into the human role of internet poster. I can has cheeseburger, invisible snow shovel, I'm in your Wikipedia, editing your articles. This is consistent with the middle focal lengths of these photos, which conveys the world in a naturalistic, human-friendly way. With the widening of lenses, cat memes look different. Cats are captured on wide-angle lenses at close range, as they tend to be, and have distorted features and dominate the environment around them. In this view, cats are not recognized for the human aspects or projected humanity, but are instead weird little guys. With the ease of sharing high-definition pictures and videos, it becomes trivial to create silly images of cats that emphasize their alien qualities. There's no claim to causation, but just some speculation that the change in the look and meaning of cat memes have proceeded in an intertwined way. I don't expect lenses will get wider, right? Especially as someone who mostly does interchangeable lens photography, smartphone cameras feel painfully wide, and using the 2x zoom shortcut on my phone is my default for taking pictures. However, the trend has held strong so far, and two camera setups with an ultra-wide option have even reached the mid-range market. Expansive fields of view are in demand, not just on smartphones, but in surveillance and everywhere in entertainment. Perhaps there will be a future change in tastes to naturalistic middle focal lengths, and distorted wide-angle pictures will become trite and associated with late 2010s, 2020s nostalgia. For now, it's hard to see any other path. The future is wide.